Hi, welcome back. Before we begin, let's do a recap of what we have covered in the part one video. In the previous video, I shared with you guys about how Jerry made use of the concept of put options as a way to protect the profits for selling his house. In that analogy, the put option that Jerry bought is valued at $50,000. And this value stays constant at $50,000 throughout. But in the financial markets, the value of put options does not stay constant. Let's get down to some of the factors that result in the change in value. And in the second part of this video today, I'll also be talking about why investors may want to buy put options. On 6 December 2021, the share price of Apple was $160. Suppose you think that Apple share prices have already rallied up by a lot, and you're afraid that the share prices may fall. So you decide to buy a put option as a protective hedge for your Apple holdings. Take note that this is just a theoretical scenario to teach the concept of put options. And I'm not implying that Apple share prices are going to come down. So you have 100 Apple shares in a portfolio currently, and you purchase a put option for Apple with a strike price of $160, expiring on 7 Jan 2022. One contract for options is for 100 shares. So for this put option, the total premium you have to pay is $540, which means that currently the value of this put option is $540. One of the factors that affect the value of options is the movement of the share price in relation to the strike price. Let's say the share price of Apple decreases to $150 one week later. How will the value of the put option change? The value of the put option in this case will now increase. As an arbitrary figure, let's just say that the value of the put option increases to $1,150. You may ask, why did the value of the put option increase in this case? From the perspective of a buyer, you want the price of Apple shares to decrease below the strike price of $160 so that you're getting a good deal by fixing the selling price of Apple shares at $160 should you decide to exercise the put option. In other words, you get to sell your Apple shares at $160 while the other investors can only sell them at $150 market price. And that makes you better off than the other investors without the put option. So this makes the put option that you hold on more valuable now. The converse is true as well. If the price of Apple shares increases to $170 a week later, the value of the put option declines to, say, $180. Since you're better off by selling your Apple shares at a price that is higher than the $160 strike price directly off the stock market, this put option is no longer that valuable to you now. So in terms of technical definition, this is what we call the intrinsic value of a put option. The intrinsic value of a put option is the value that you get by taking the strike price minus the market price of the stock. When market price declines below the strike price, intrinsic value becomes a positive number. Then, when the market price increases up higher than the strike price, intrinsic value declines to zero. Another factor which I mentioned before that affects the value of an option is the time decay. As time decays nearer to the expiration date, the value of the put option declines. This is because you have less time and less potential for the share price to move in the direction that is in your favor, which in this case is for the share price to decrease below the strike price. Time decay also makes up part of the extrinsic value of the put option. Now that you have a better understanding of how and why the value of put options fluctuates, let's take a look at how investors can benefit from buying put options. Before I continue, this video is for educational purposes on understanding the concept of put options from a buyer's perspective, and it should not be construed as a recommendation of any put option strategies. The first reason is to hedge your position in the underlying shares. This works just like insurance, where you pay a premium and you get insured for a certain amount. When you buy a put option, you lock in the selling price of your shares at a price level which you are comfortable selling at, while at the same time, you continue to enjoy potential increase in profits if the share prices increases. So the maximum loss that you will incur is the premium that you pay for the put option. In the case of the Apple stock example in the previous video, you are paying a premium of $540 to insure or to protect $16,000 of Apple stocks. When will investors want to do this? Usually, investors may want to buy a put option to protect their portfolio during times when they think that a crash or a price decline is imminent. But of course, they could be wrong about the price decline and the price ends up going up. So they get to continue to enjoy the increase in capital gains by still holding on to their shares. And the cost that they pay in this case is the put option premium. This could be a strategy for them to take when investors are holding on to at least 100 shares of a particular stock. And so they buy a put option of that stock. Another way investors can go about using put options as a buyer is to buy a put option on the ETF that tracks the market that they are mainly invested in. For example, a put option on the SPY ETF. You may choose to do this when you do not have 100 shares in your stock's portfolio, but you would still like to hedge against the potential bearish momentum by buying a put option on the ETF that has a strong correlation to your stock's portfolio. The second reason is to buy a put option as an alternative way to shorting a stock. But this reason of buying a put option would be more applicable for the traders than for the investors. This is because traders may be speculating on the price decline to profit from it. But as investors, we are generally looking to profit from price increases in the stock markets. The advantage of buying a put option over shorting a stock directly is that the absolute amount of losses is capped at the put premium amount that you pay. Whereas if you short a stock directly, the losses can be unlimited, depending on how high the stock prices increase to. So that's the end of my sharing on put options, and I hope that you now have a better understanding of what put options are and how they work.